In this illustration, we'll study about the collision of two fired shells. We are given that a cannon fires two shells with the velocity 250 meters per second at an angle 60 degree and 45 degree to horizontal. And here we are required to find the time interval between firing so that the two shells will collide in mid-air. Here, if we draw the situation here, you can see if these are the XY coordinate system and a cannon fires from the initial point two shells at an angle 45 degree and 60 degree to the horizontal, and in this situation their trajectory intersects at this point, say P. And if the two shells are fired in such a way that they are going to collide at this point P, because this is the point where the trajectories are intersecting. So if they collide, they'll collide only at this point. And the time taken by the two shells will obviously be different here. If this shell, which is fired at an angle 60 degree, which is taking longer path, say takes a time T1 in reaching P, and the other one is taking a time T2 in reaching P, then the time difference between firing of the shells so that they'll collide is delta T, and this must be T1 minus T2. Now, in this situation, if the coordinates of the point P are x, y, then in this situation here we can use at point P, we use here the value of x is, this is the distance traveled in horizontal direction by the two particles. So here we can write it 250 cos 60 degree multiplied by T1, which is the horizontal component of velocity of a projectile which is thrown at an angle 60 degree. The same can be written as 250 cos 45 degree T2. So in this situation, if we simplify, this will give us T1 by 2 is equals to T2 by root 2. Or here we can write T1 is equals to root 2 T2. Say this is our equation 1. And for y coordinate of this point here, we can write again y is equals to 250 sine 60 degree T1 minus half g T1 squared. That is the y component, or the y displacement of particle from initial point for the particle thrown at 60 degree, and the one which is thrown at 45 degree takes time T2 in reaching P. So for this we can write 250 sine 45 degree into T2 minus half g T2 square. Now in this situation, here we can substitute the value of T1 as root 2 T2. So this will be 250, here sine 60 degree can be written as root 3 by 2 multiplied by T1, we can write as root 2 T2 minus half g, this is root 2 T2 square, so this will be 2 T2 square is equals to, this is 250 by root 2 T2 minus half g T2 square. Here this is square and T2 gets cancelled out, and on simplifying this, you can see what we are getting is, this will be 125 root 3 multiplied by root 2 minus, here this can be written as g by 2, we can write as 5 into 2, this 10 T2 is equals to, this can be further written as 125 root 2 minus this 5 T2. So on further simplifying, this will become 5 T2, or T2 is equals to, this can be written as 25 root 2 multiplied by root 3 minus 1 second. So if this T2, on substituting here, we can get the value of T1 from equation 1. And if we substitute the value of T2 here, this will be 50 multiplied by root 3 minus 1 second. So as we have got the value of T2 and T1, we can find out the time difference between the firing of these two shells so that these will collide in midair. This can be written as T1 minus T2. So on substituting the values, this is 50 multiplied by root 3 minus 1 multiplied by 1 minus 1 by root 2. And numerically, when you solve it, this will give you 10.77 seconds. That is the final result of this problem.